Asalias. What we end up seeing is actually the word for kingdom within the Baterimon, the Our Father in the... You know, it's interesting to me because when I think about the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God, I think of that, Vasalia, but also Aliyah itself and the connection of that raising, actually edifying and being lifted up. What is it to make Aliyah? To ascend to the Holy Land, to ascend to the kingdom of God. But how do we even understand the kingdom of heaven? Jesus uses it. He talks about the Malchus, Malchus, the Shema Chaim. Now there's this amazing picture that they have whenever you walk into Sfat Israel. They have these art galleries there where they take the ideas and the perception of the Jewish faith and they use it in an artistic manner. They call this the Sphira, the Yetzhari, or the Arbor, maybe that, as we end up looking at it, from when Kabbalah originated in southern Spain, actually shows you forth these characteristics of both the pillar of severity and mercy and how they end up showing the duality of God's mercy in accordance with his grace. So thus, the merciful receive mercy. But because of that severity, we understand the concepts of justification, purification, sanctification, and how this leads into glorification. Now, at the top of this sphere, what we end up seeing is the crown, the keser, and it's connected. Now, they talk about the G or the roof, but I'm ecstatic. That means body. And so when we talk about the Rosh, or the head, or the peg, it's the nose. It runs it as an idea of the different conceptions. Pause.